So we're in the car on our way to Craigley Ski Club. We're going to look at the chairs there that they have built, and we're going to take some measurements so that I know dimensions and stuff for building mine. And then we're going to go to Home Hardware and get a table saw blade that can cut through metal and stuff, get whatever else we need, then we're going to head back to the house and start building. So we're here at Craigley Ski Club. These are the skis that I'm modeling my chair after. And just taking measurements and counts of all the things we need, screws, bolts, nuts, skis, all that stuff. And we're going to go down to the Home Hardware and get all the stuff we don't have, head back to the house and start building. So in order to cut the pieces, we first have to know which ones are going where. So we looked at all the different skis and decided which ones we would use for the back pieces. Gray atomics in the middle with both pairs of red atomics on either side. Not only because that looks cool with the little descending red parts there, but also because for the armrest, which is made up of a tip, we thought that would be better if it was flat like the vocals here, flat and wide, which is perfect. And then we decided that the smallest ones would be good supports. So that's how it's going to be. So in case you've ever wondered what a severed ski edge looks like, this is it. It came out of one of the skis. So the old saw blade couldn't even get through this piece of wood. It almost did, but not quite. And it sent smoke everywhere. So we're replacing it with this brand new one that we bought yesterday. The old one.
Dull the blade tips are.
Yeah. This'll be fun. Here's where all the smoke came from before. Oh my god. It's a thing of beauty.
So, that piece goes wrong.
It's 100 times easier. So, finally, at 12:30 on the second day of cutting, we finished cutting all the skis. Now we just have a little bit of wood to do and we're ready to start assembling.